Bonjour, bonjour, fragrance lover. Welcome back to my channel. In today's video, we're talking about one brand. It's Fragrance One by Jeremy Fragrance. So before we start the video, I've changed my microphone, so please tell me in the comment if it's not great. Still don't know how to use it properly. And also I changed the luminosity. Yes. And yeah, that's it. So please follow me on Instagram and subscribe to my channel. Leave me a little like to encourage me to improve the quality of this channel, please. Anyway, in today's video, I'm pretty glad to talk about Jeremy's fragrance. So for those who don't know who is Jeremy, he's basically the most popular influencer, perfume reviewer, hashtag blogger. Basically, Jeremy decided to create his own brand, which is a fragrance one. So I was really curious since a few months now to try these fragrances. Only because, I'm a perfume reviewer as well, I mean, kind of thing like that. And we're sharing the same passion, and I really encourage the fragrance community to create the perfume. I think it's great. I was glad to discover it, especially from Jeremy, because I think he's the most popular one. So I didn't meet Jeremy myself. I heard that he was a really nice guy. I know he's quite controversial because some people's been very tough with him, and you can critique, but basically today we're not gonna talk about the person, we're gonna talk about his fragrance. So that's it. And no matter all the critique is, no matter what I think or things like that, if I'm being objective, I would say that I admire his courage to create his brand, because you need to be very brave, because you know that you will get more criticism because you're criticizing brands every day. So It's really difficult. So people are expecting a lot from you, and so I really admire that, and I can only respect this. I've seen a lot of reviews about it, and first of all, I went to Fragrantica and I've read some comments, and I was just shocked how people are tough with those fragrances. And I'm like, this is not nice. I think you're judging the fragrance. So that's why today I really want to be objective and to really tell you if I do like it or not, and things like that, and when I think about it. So there's two fragrances I'm gonna try today, and it's Office and Date. First thing to say, I quite like the concept of it, because it's a fragrance for each time of the day, and I think it's great because it can please everyone. You've got your fragrance for office, your fragrance for date. I don't know what he's gonna do after, maybe for clubbing or stuff like that, I don't know. But I think it's quite cool because for me, it's satisfying me because it's well organized, first of all. And second, also, I think for beginners in fragrance that want a fragrance for each occasion, not sure what to take, it's difficult, you know, it's not easy to choose a fragrance, then I think this is the perfect concept, definitely. So I think it's very smart because he's been thinking of how I'm gonna attract a lot of people that don't know me or things like that. So I think he's very clever. It's a clever move. So it's simple, it's easy, it's efficient. So this is, I think, a good way to do marketing. So considering that concept, before smelling the fragrance, I was expecting something not complicated, easy to wear, and can please everyone. That was what I expected. Of course, I heard things before and I was like, nee. But yeah, so this is not my first try. I've been trying it before, and also I've been trying during a full day as well, and I'm wearing it, the two of them in my palm since this morning, and I'm gonna respray to give you my first impression and blah 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 and what I think about. But before we go, just to give you a little note on the perfumer, because I always like to share about the amazing perfumers, and this is just Alberto Morillas. So no matter what you can say, no matter if you don't like it, Alberto is a master perfumer. He's been there during ages, and he's been creating most of the fragrance you might like. And also he received the Prix François Coty in 2013, 2003, and also he received the Fragrance Foundation Award for something like Master Perfumer in 2013, so 10 years after, which is great. I'm gonna list you some of my favorite fragrance from him, and to give you a noise. So we have Colonia Intensa by Acqua di Parma, Bulgari Man, Omnia India, Indian Garnet. I don't know if you tried this one, but this I cherish it for my holidays. Then you have Voulez-vous coucher avec moi, Kilian, CK1, Acqua di Gio, Hot Couture by Givenchy, Gucci Bloom, and from Gucci, The Voice of the Snake, which is my favorite exclusive from them. Flower by Kenzo, Marc Jacob Daisy, Lord George by Ben Alligans, that I really like. But overall, all of these fragrances got really like an uplifting effect, like not all of them, but he really likes to play with something like quite fresh, sometimes like more casual chic, I would say, style, which I really enjoy. So it's, I think, his little touch. So let's get on Office. So I had little discount. I didn't buy the bottle first, and I'm gonna explain to you why at the end as well. So this is Office for Men, so I'm gonna respray it. Voilà. So the first impression when I really smell it is like an intoxication of fruit. It's like, bam, here's the fruit. And a bit of spice as well, and greenness behind, which is quite nice, I think. So before I'm giving my other impression, let's talk about the ingredients. So apparently, it's related to Fragrantica, but on the website, you can't see what's the note inside, which is a bit annoying. It tells you a little bit about it, but not too much. So there's orris, ambroxan, bergamote, ambre gris, jasmine, floral notes, woody notes, amber, patchouli and musk. So what I can smell really at the beginning is really the ambroxan effect, and it's really like have a little bit of sweetness because it's surrounded by fruit, so that's why I think he's uplifting the fruit and give the impression of, there you go, here are the fruits. So it's really like an uplifting and fresh effect at the beginning, at the opening of the fragrance. That's what you get straight away. And then after, I can smell a bit of like cleanness to it. That's probably gonna be something like musky and ambergris mixed together, because it's got like that marine freshness, nearly very green, very like clean at the end. And then I can smell, with a bit of time, a little bit more of sensitivity. And when I say sensitivity, is like it had probably like a little touch of flower, which I think is lovely, and that gives like a little softness to the fragrance. It's after the fruitiness effect, dry down to something a bit more powdery, slightly. It's like the orris, I think it's the orris that gives the powdery effect, like encapsulated all the fragrance and created like a powdery note, which I think is really pretty. And dry down, that's the part I really enjoy the most, I think, because you can really smell like something much more ambery on the dry down, and a bit more green as well. We smell nearly like a touch foresty, not too much, and it's got like a warmth that is coming after, and I think it's really nicely done, because it's not something extremely attacking you. I think it's very elegant, and it's perfect for office basically, because you're not gonna intoxicate everyone, even though the opening is very strong. After, it really something a bit more warmer and not too strong. So this freshness and very vivid start, I can really compare it to a Sauvage from Dior. I can really smell that. This is probably the Ambroxan that is very a bit the same in the two fragrances, and we know that Jeremy loves the Sauvage, so I think he wanted something maybe like that for office. So I can really see the similarities. I can also scent like a touch of mintiness to it, but not too strong. That probably makes me think of Aventures, but not that much to be honest, but a little bit. And then at the end, it dries a bit more green and peppery. I don't know why it smells pepper, but much more warmer. And at the beginning, I had just a little feeling of terre d'Hermès, like a bit zesty, which I really enjoyed. After, no, but just a little bit, you know. I feel that it's a good office fragrance because it's not too much, and it's got a little bit of sensuality as well. For the longevity, I mean, I kept it the whole morning. I couldn't smell it that much after like 4 or 5 hours. But again, it depends on my skin, and I spray it on the palm, and it's not the best place for. I felt it was not that bad for the longevity, even though it stays quite discreet at the end with all the warmth. And I mean, overall, if I have to say, I think the fragrance is functional, it's working, it's perfectly equivalent to the theme, which is office. It's also more comparable to a designer for me. I think it's really that scent that is an easy to wear, nice to wear, and I think that a lot of people can enjoy. And that's why, you know, for a gift or for someone that you don't know what they like, I think this is working every time. I think it's like, it's a good fragrance for me, what I have to say. It smells also masculine, but there's a touch of like a sensibility to it, which I really appreciate. And I think, again, it's a really safe choice for me. So that's it for office. Let's go for the date. Date was, for me, a bit more complicated, I have to say. So where is my date? It's here. So I'm spraying in the other hand. Okay, so it's supposed to be an oriental fruity in this one. And I'm gonna read a little sentence. I wanted to check some information before, and I found this little word from Fragrance One in their website, which is: the fruity opening is the flirtiness on a date, the laugh and smile, the rich meets through patchouli and cardamom. I can't read myself, it's stupid. Brings the seduction. Then we have the immortality masculine wood and super sexual vetiver. I didn't know vetiver were super sexual. But for me it's more earthy, elegant, casual chic. I don't know. Anyway, so I sprayed it there. I didn't even bring it to my nose, that I can smell it everywhere. And like, it was really intense. Like, the opening compared to office is like, it's even stronger. It's like, oh, the first time I sprayed it, I was like, oh Jesus, I had to step back because it was a lot. And I think that's what he wanted to do, like something like a bomb, like exploding. And this really makes me think of something from Paco Rabanne, that at the beginning is extremely intense. He like gives you everything, like he's attacking you. If you're on a date, it's like the man is taking anyway. But yeah, let's talk about the composition. So you've got bergamot, lemon, orange, juniper, berries, patchouli, cardamom, vetiver, and oud. So really what I can feel at the beginning strongly is the fruitiness. It's really a fruity fragrance for me. So it says it's supposed to be an oriental fruity. For me, it's like much more stronger in the fruit. Like I can smell the fruit straight away. And especially, the fruit's got a little sharpness, but nearly like candied-like, nearly like a bonbon. It's quite a sugary, fruity. I think it's the mandarin orange as well that gives that a little bit. And the lemon is very citrusy, lemony, bonbon-like, very candied. So that's why it's like really attacking you at the beginning. Compared to the office one that is a bit more sharper fruit, this one is like a strong, candied fruit for me. So it's just like basically you're dropping your fruity cocktail on the floor and it suddenly smells everywhere. So at the beginning, I didn't like it. For me, the opening is way too strong, and I really, really had, after it's very subjective, you know, but for me, I struggled with the opening. I thought it was a bit strong. Then after, I get something a bit more like foresty green. I think it's the juniper berries. It usually had a little bit of like greenness tone to it, and the vetiver as well. So it really was to have a little weight. So I feel like if you just spray on the blotter, you would probably run, but after sometimes it really had a nice dry down. And what I get now is something much more warmer, rounder, comforting. It's still like very sharp and strong, but much more warmer. And it's something that he says that there's a masculine oud. I can't smell oud inside. I think it's covered by the fruitiness. Overall, I think it's something that, like, for me, easy to wear for any gender. Like, if you like, if ladies like a fruity accord, I feel this is working. Because I don't see that masculine for me. So as an oriental lover, I would have expect much more oriental note, like much more oud, much more, I don't know, like vanilla, amber, like something like this, you know. And I get like something much more fruitier, so I'm a bit, it's not my style basically. And I don't know, I feel a bit like of mintiness behind, I don't know what it is really, probably it's the greenness that gives that. That's a bit annoying me. I think it's definitely a good date fragrance. I would probably imagine a guy wearing them, like probably a sporty guy, you know, and going on a date with a very traditional date thing, you know, with a shirt or tie or something like that. That could work. I don't see anyone like very with a sharp style, you know, like hipster or something like that, wearing this. After, I can be wrong, but I feel really like it's Jeremy fragrance profile, so I think he looks like him, which is great. I think for sure you would give a great impression if you're wearing that, that's for sure. Because overall I can't say it smells bad at all, like not a really fruity person. I would prefer to have some more depth to the fragrance, but if I have to choose between the two, I will definitely take The Office. I think The Office is really interesting. I really actually really like it. This for me is really nicely done, really nicely done, and I feel it's very elegant, and I would definitely see a gentleman wearing this. After, it's not something groundbreaking, it's not, it's probably like more like an easy safe choice for the two, to be honest. Even though the date, you need to appreciate the fruitiness of it, so I would say you need to try it before. But for office, I think it's really nice. I think it's really really nice. I would definitely see this kind of fragrance released by a designer brand for sure in perfumery store. This could fit really well. So I think overall it perfectly matched the concept. The two scents perfectly match the concept, the name, and I think it's really well done. So I don't know why, like I've seen those fragrances like being teared down, or I've seen them in, you know, when we've done that worst hated fragrance of 2019 on Fragrantica, it was there, and I'm like, no, it's not bad fragrance at all, I think it's really nice. But I prefer Office as well. So I would say be kind in the comment, and there's a little thing I need to say as well, the packaging. So the prices for 100 milliliters for Office is 159 euros. So for us in pound, it will be 170, a bit more maybe. Probably a bit more, 180. I don't know how much it is. Like I've checked the price in euros, but yeah, it's really expensive for me. Like it's really expensive, just because when you see Chanel or Dior or I don't know, whatever, like designer kind of fragrance, like having the bestseller fragrance much less than this for the same amount of liquid, I'm like, I think it's a bit ambitious. After, I don't know what's inside, and that's where it's a shame. Because if you would have put in the website where the ingredient come from, how did Alberto Morillas work to do his fragrance, like show us a little video, maybe something about the creation, show us more about how is it made, how it's exquisite, you know, things like that, then I would probably pay the price, you know. Especially for The Office, like I wouldn't mind to have a bottle, but there was none of that. It's really simple. I didn't have an explanation to understand why the price is so expensive. And then when you look at the bottle, I mean, it's a nice bottle. I like the fact that it's really classic, elegant. It can go to a gentleman's bag really easily. But I'm like, For the price, I would expect something a bit more detailed and something like that. So it's just the price really that is annoying, because the rest is really good. And the date one is 219 euros, so in pound is even more. And I'm like, I don't see having the same, I don't know, for me it's not like you, he's on the same price point as Tom Ford, and I'm like, especially for your first fragrances. I understand maybe he wants to do like a Tom Ford kind of stuff, but I just no, like, it's too much, it's really too expensive. That's my only thing I'm gonna say. It was really nice to try them. I'm really happy because I was waiting for that for ages. Please tell me what you think if you tried them before. Recommend to everyone to be really kind in the comment with each other, and to not talk about the person. We're not here to debate about what he does and what he say and stuff like that. We're here to debate about the fragrance. So that's it. So please stay objective, as I was objective, even though, you know, you have things to say and blah, 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 blah. But yes, and that's it for me today. So I hope you enjoy, and I will see you soon. Bye bye now.